Bismillah Rahman Rahim. Welcome to the PL-300 Microsoft Power BI Data Analyst Exam Preparation Course. The PL-300 certification leads to the title of Power BI Data Analyst Associate. The Power BI Data Analyst works closely with business stakeholders to identify business requirements. They collaborate with enterprise data analysts and data engineers to identify and acquire data. They also transform the data, create data models, visualize data, and share assets by using Power BI. So the definition that you see here has been copied and pasted here from the Microsoft Learn website. And this is effectively the overall role of a Power BI data analyst and the things that a Power BI data analyst is supposed to do. So in order to pass this certification, you must make sure that you understand what is the overall role of a Power BI data analyst, and you will have to learn all the things that have been mentioned here on this slide. The PL-300 certification exam has been divided into four learning paths. So the first learning path is prepare the data, which has an overall weightage of 25 to 30% on the exam. The second learning path is model the data, which again has a weightage of 25 to 30% on the exam. The third learning path is visualize and analyze the data. Again, the overall weightage is 25 to 30%. And the last learning path is deploy and maintain assets, which has a weightage of 15 to 20% on the PL-300 exam. Here is the detailed content for the first learning path, prepare the data. So within each learning path, you have multiple sections. So this is the first section, get data from data sources. The second section is clean the data, and the third section is transform and load the data. Within each section, you have multiple topics that are shown here in the bullet points. The same methodology is followed for all the learning paths. So you can see that I have listed here the second learning path, which is model the data. These are the three sections inside model the data, and for each section you can see the different topics. Similarly, for the third learning path, visualize and analyze the data, we have sections create reports, enhance reports for usability and storytelling, and the third section is identify patterns and trends. So again, you can see there are multiple sections for the third learning path, and for within each section you have multiple topics. And then the last learning path is deploy and maintain assets. Here you have two sections, create and manage workspaces and assets, and manage data sets. And then again you have multiple topics for the two sections shown here for the fourth learning path. So we are going to cover each and every topic in order to prepare for this exam. So in the subsequent sections, you are going to find that the overall course has been divided as per the four learning paths shown here. I have changed the distribution and the sequence of these topics slightly based on the experience that how the student would find it most appropriate to prepare for the exam. But all the topics that you see here listed on these slides have been covered and covered in a lot of detail. I have also attached a PDF document that is titled the PL-300 cheat sheet or important points to remember. So I have prepared this document based upon my own understanding, and I would strongly recommend you to use this cheat sheet while you are preparing for the exam. If you feel that you want to add some more points to this cheat sheet, feel free to do that and make your own cheat sheet. But you are going to find a lot of things, important things that are related to the exam that have been covered in this cheat sheet. Most of the content in this course is hands-on. So you are going to find that almost 85 to the 90% of the content is based on hands-on. And there is a lot of course material that is required to actually follow in the videos. So any data set or any other supporting material is available on two sources. The first one is the Google Drive, and the other one is the Microsoft SharePoint. As soon as you register for your course, you are going to get access to the Google Drive. In case you do not get access or are facing any issue accessing the Google Drive link, then feel free to drop me an email in the link shown on the bottom of this video. The other link is the Microsoft SharePoint. In the videos, I have used this Microsoft SharePoint link, but you do not need to worry. Everything that is there on the Microsoft SharePoint link is also available on the Google Drive. For the last learning path, which is the fourth learning path, you will require access to Power BI service. So if you require access to Power BI service and you do not have an account of your own, then once you reach the fourth learning path, please drop an email and I will give access to you on the SharePoint account that I have. But remember that this SharePoint account access will be available for just 30 days. So make sure that you watch the fourth learning path and do everything related to the Power BI service within that month. Apart from the fourth learning path, everything on the course requires you to have Power BI Desktop installed on your Windows machine. And please remember that Power BI Desktop does not run on your MacBooks. So if you do not have access to Power BI Desktop, you can just come on this website and click here on this link and you can download Power BI Desktop on your laptop or on your Windows machine. You can put this link on your browser and come here and download the Power BI Desktop software. Otherwise, you can just use any search engine and write Power BI Desktop and it is going to bring you to the same link and you can download the Power BI Desktop environment on your Windows machine or laptop. If you want to interact with the instructor in case of any question or query, you can join the Skype group link, which is shown here on this hyperlink. Or in case you are unable to join this link, then you can drop me an email on the email address that was shown earlier in the video. If you like the content of this course, then you can also use these social media handles to interact with me. I am very active on all these links. So that's all for the introduction of the course. So you can now start watching all the videos. There are certain videos that are mentioned as reference or optional videos. So my recommendation would be that you should go and always watch or read the reference articles or reference videos. But the optional videos or the optional articles, it is up to you whether you want to go into the detail or you do not have the time, then you can easily skip those. So that's it for the course introduction, and I'll catch up with you in the next video.